Right.
Dave's ex-Black Watch. I'm ex-Air Force. Right. Another bloke up there is...
the camera, I don't know how well it'll come out over there. No.
display in a cabinet. There's something within you. Which felt like they'd been left over from World War One. So when we were posted to our squadrons to fly Spitfires and Hurricanes, we had some cash and I could do the model of the aircraft, and we did that on the Narrows Master. The models of the Audax came far back in the morning. Thank you.
This is one here. There was only 1,000 of this model made. 500 went across the RAF Lucasella, 500 went down to Wales. Her top speed was only 750 miles per hour, but in those dives she would break the speed of sound. Okay, in 1955, a pilot had to eject. Many broken bones, but he was back up flying quite recent after that. So you can see we took the skin off the edge of this aircraft so you can see the workings. So our engine starts from the white bit all the way to the very end. And as you can see, she's only got one seat. So men mainly flew this aircraft, women flew her from manufacturers to base or base to base, okay? Yeah. Her daughter across here, she's a tornado. She is only 20 years old. We've only had her exactly 1 year this year, this month. We only got her last year in June. So you can see that she's got two seats. Pilot sits at the front, the person does everything else that's in the back. Rick, they're filming, so if you don't want to be on film.
Sorry.
So, her top speed is 1,500 miles per hour.
That's about Mach 2, yeah?
No, she's a Mach...
Mach 2.
Oh, she has a Mach 2, sorry. I do apologise, yes. Actually, Rick here would be better telling you all about her, because he's Royal Air Force where I am Army, so...
Hi there. I didn't work on these particular ones, but I did work on the Tornado fighter version, the F3. So it's all 80% of the airframe is the same.
Is this the bomb or the train?
This is the bomber.
The bomber.
Yeah.
God, they're some size.
Yeah, the F3 was actually slightly longer to accommodate the missiles in the belly.
Right.
We put four Sky Flash or AMRAAM as they are now, but they had to put in an extra. Oh, I think it was about 3-4 foot, I can't remember off the top of my head. Mm. So the actual navigator sits forward of the air intake on a Tornado F3.
Right.
But here he's back. So it's longer, and then the nose was a lot more pointy. They were slightly faster.
Is the navigator the weapons guy as well?
Yes, they changed the name from navigator to weapon systems operator just before I left the RAF.
When did you leave?
November 2010.
Oh, okay. Now, I was Army for 15 years.
Dave's ex-Black Watch. I'm ex-Air Force. Another bloke up there is, I think it was Remy.
Is he?
Or something like that.
I can't remember.
Or Royal Engineers. It was one of those. I think it was in one of those departments. I can't remember which one. Yeah. And there's quite a few of us actually here. They're all ex-forces here.
Yeah. I wish I stayed close on and I could come in and, you know, as a volunteer sort of thing.
Well, I live in Dundee, but I come up a couple of Sundays and I just clean all the jets, wipe all the dust and clean the jets up and that.
We're over in Argyll, so it's
a bit further to go.
4 hour drive, yeah.
Yeah. A bit far.
It's just
these are engines from a different aircraft.
Right. I've never heard of that one, but never mind. Is that the engine mate guy?
These are all Rolls Royce. The RAF uses all Rolls-Royce engines, as they are now, but it went into... This one was in the Vulcan. You had four of those in the Vulcan.
Oh, Jesus, I remember these. No, we used to live in a place called Cairnban.
Yeah.
And every Friday, there'd be one flying hell of a low.
Mm.
And it was something to do with... They were testing the radars up at Benbecula.
Yeah.
So every Friday... came up low as hell, and geez, they were some science wings.
Spray, these were the ones that went in the Phantom aircraft, and also in the Nimrods. But they took the reheat off the Nimrod version, because they didn't want to rip the wings off it.
Yeah. So did you get a chance to actually fly them?
I was a weapons technician.
Oh, you were waiting.
So I worked all that, ejection seats, guns, bombs, missiles. But I did manage to get a back seat from the Tornado F3 when I was on 111 Squadron, which was fun.
I only ever managed to get in the helicopter when I was in the Army once. And that was just a quick, you know, bloody mad.
Yeah. Also, when I was on Nimbus, one of the pilots, when we were going across the Atlantic, he decided he'd try and race Concorde. He lost.
Yeah.
You see your two seats at the front, so the pilot sits at the very front
And the one
and
right
then the person
who
does like the bombing and everything else sits at the back. This is not a bomb.
They're a lot bigger than I thought they were.
That's what I said. Look at the tail wing off on its own there.
That is not a bomb, it's on our wing, by the way, folks.
No, that's an extra fuel tank,
isn't
it?
That's a fuel tank, yeah.
And it just fits, and it just fits in.
Yes.
So.
And dismantled and put back together, wonderful.
Yeah.
Good stuff, you're doing a good
and
job.
I just take the fin off, take the two wings off, put the tailor
just
on.
Just say that like it was, yeah.
It is literally held together with, that's how they were built.
I know, I'm not sure we'd have to go up anymore.
I've been up in a tornado with three when I was when I worked on Treble One Squadron at Lucas.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was fun. And you really enjoyed that.
You're
not the coming down bit afterwards.
No.
The bit of air sickness. But we'll leave that conversation
there.
At least it wasn't in the air, it's when I got down.